The next properties of whole numbers. Then first property, closure property. Closure property. Then we can say whole numbers are closed under addition. That means when we add two whole number, sum of two whole number is a whole number. Means for example, 3 is a whole number. 3 plus 4 is equal to addition. Then 3 plus 4 is equal to which number? 7 is equal to 7. Then 3 is a whole number, 4 also whole number. And its answer is look a whole number. Means whole number plus whole number is equal to whole number. So we can say that whole numbers are closed under addition. Sum of any two whole number is a whole number. Is it clear? Then next multiplication. Multiplication, whole numbers are closed under multiplication. That means when we product of two whole number is a whole number. When we multiply any two whole number, its answer is also a whole number. For example, look, 3 multiply 4 is equal to 12, or 8 multiply 0 is equal to what is answer? Look, 0. Here 3 is whole number and 4 is whole number, and its answer also whole number. Then 8 is whole number, 0 is whole number. So answer, what is answer? 0. 0 is also whole number. Means whole number multiply whole number is a whole number. So we can say that whole numbers are closed under multiplication. Here addition and multiplication, look, whole numbers are closed under addition and multiplication. Then next you look subtraction and division. Subtraction. Look here, 4 minus 3 is equal to 1. This is a whole number. Then another whole, look, 3 minus 5. What is its answer? Do you know its answer is, I write here, negative 2. Negative 2 is not a whole number. Then look here, when we subtract any two whole number, look, do you get the same whole number? Here we get may or may not whole number. So we can say that whole numbers are not closed under subtraction. Whole numbers are not closed under subtraction. Then next, in case of division, what happened? Look here, division. Look, 8 divided by 4. What is answer? 2. Here, 8 divided by 4 is whole number. Then look, 5 divided by 3. Do you get a whole number? 5 is completely divided by 3. No, 5 by 3 is not a whole number. And another, 8 divided by 0. What is answer? Do you know? This answer is, its answer is not, is not defined. So we can say that division, look, division and subtraction, whole numbers are not closed under division. When we divide any two number, we not get whole number. May or may not we get answer. So we can say that whole numbers are not closed under division and subtraction. Is it clear? The next property, next property is commutativity. Commutative property. Then first addition. addition is commutative. Addition is commutative. Means when we change the order of any two whole number in addition. In case of addition, look, its answer is same. When we change the order of any two whole number, then 2 plus 3 is equal to, look, 3 plus 2. Look, here 2 plus 3. First we write 2 plus 3. Then we change its order. First we write second number and second write first number. Here we change the order. What happened? Any change here? Answer is same. 3 plus 2 plus 3 and 3 plus 2 is which answer? 5. Then we changing the order of any two whole number in addition. Answer is sum is same. Is it clear? The next multiplication, look. A and B are two whole number. A plus B is equal to B plus A in addition. Then when we two whole number A and B. Then two whole number A and B. A multiply B is equal to B multiply A. So answer is same. For example, look. 3 multiply 5 is equal to 5 multiply 3. Look, here we change the order of the number. What happened? Nothing, means answer is same. Product is same product. 3 multiply 5 is 15, or 5 multiply 3 also 15. So when we change the order of the number in multiplication, product is same. Is it clear? Then next you look what happened in. So we can say that addition and multiplication are commutative. Addition and multiplicative are commutative. Then what happened in case of subtraction? In case of subtraction, look, 4 minus 3 is equal to 3 minus 4, 4 minus 3 is equal to 1. So 3 minus 4 is 1, not. So we can say here 4 minus 3 not equal to 3 minus 4. What is your answer? 4 minus 3 is 1, not equal to, what is its answer, do you know? Negative 1. So 1 is not equal to negative 1. So we can say that subtraction is not commutative. Then in division, case of division, we can look. Then when we change the order of the numbers, look, 8 divided by 4 is equal to 4 divided by 8. Look, 8 divided by 5, 4 which number? 2. 4 divided by 8 which number? 4 divided by 8. What is number? 1 by 2. Here 1 by 2. Is equal? Not equal. So we can say that division is not commutative. Here which addition and multiplication are commutative, but subtraction and division are not commutative. Is it clear? The next property. Third property, associative property of addition and multiplication. Addition and addition and multiplication. Here addition and multiplication are associative. That means 3 or sum or product of 3 or more than 3 numbers are remain same. When we change the grouping of the number. For example, look, A, B, C are any three number. Then A plus B plus C is equal to A plus B plus C. We can find out the answer. Sum or product we can find out in different way. Look, A plus B plus C or A plus B bracket plus C. For example, look, 3, 4, 6. Then three numbers. Any three number we can take. A is equal to 3, B is equal to 4, and C is equal to 6. Then we can apply that. Look, A is 3. 3 plus 4 plus 6 is equal to 3 plus 4 plus 6. Here look, group first we add this two number, last two number, 4 plus 6. 4 plus 6 which number? 10. This 10 add with the first number 3. Then what is this answer? This answer is 3 plus 10 is 30. Then now you look, first we add this first number A and B, means 3 plus 4. 3 plus 4 is 7 plus 6. 7 plus 3 which number? 7 plus 3 also 30. So look here, any change? Note this number, this 3 number we can add any way. We get the answer is remain. So we can say addition is associative. Is it clear? Then next, A, B, C are in case of multiplication. Look, here A is 3, B is 4, and C is 6. Then look, here in case of multiplication, A multiply. Then look, A multiply product of B and C. And here next look, C multiply product of A and B. First 3 into 4 into 6 is equal to 3 into 4 into 6. Look here, order change, group change here. Then first we multiply, solve inside the bracket. Bracket will come. First we solve inside the bracket. Look, 4 3s are 4 6 are 24. 24 multiply which number? 3. And here look, 3 4s are 12. Then 12 multiply 6. Look here, 23 into 24 which number? 3 into 24, 72. And here look, 72, 6 are which number? 72. Look, answer is same. So we can say multiplication is associative. Is it clear? The next property. The next fourth property, distributivity of multiplication over addition. The next property, distributivity of multiplication over addition. For example, A, B, C are 3 whole number. So look, A into B plus C is equal to A into B plus B into, sorry, A into C. This is distributive of multiplication over addition. For example, look here, A, B, C, we can take any number 2, 3, 7. A is equal to 2, B is equal to 3, and C is equal to 7. Look, at the place of A, we write 2 into 3 plus 7. Then bracket is equal to A into B. A into B means 2 into 3. 2 into 3 plus 2 into 7. Then look, first 2 multiply which number? First we add solve the inside the bracket. 3 plus 7 which number? 10. Then look, LHS right side. 2 3s are 6. Then plus 2 7s are 40. Look here, LHS side, look left hand side, 2 into 10 which number? 20. And 6 into 14 which number? 20. So here look, LHS equal to RHS. So this property is called, then so we can, this property is distributivity of multiplication, distributivity of multiplication over addition. Then next, then 0 is the additive inverse of whole number. Zero is the additive inverse of whole number. For example, that means when we add any whole number to zero, what is answer? We get that same whole number. For example, 8 add with zero. What is answer? 8. Or 0 plus 11. What is answer? We get that same number. Then any whole number add to zero, what we get? That is same whole number. So we can say 0 is the additive inverse of whole number. The next 1 is the multiplicative. Inverse of whole numbers. Then 1 is the multiplicative inverse of the whole number. For example, what is its meaning? Then 1 multiply any whole number, we get that same whole number. Means 8 multiply 1. What is answer? We get 8. Then 126. This is whole number. Then multiply by 1. What is answer? We get 126. So we get, so say 1 is the multiplicative inverse of whole number. Is it clear? Then okay. Thank you.